Hello, class. I wanted to talk to you today a little bit about the rubrics that you'll see for the grading of your essays. When you are in your paper assignment, you'll notice that there is a link to the rubric in there, so you can open that and take a look at all of the details. This is what it will look like. It'll break down each of the letter grades and give you a description of each one, so you can have an understanding of that. It reminds you to submit your paper on time, that we use the safe assigned time, date, and timestamp to determine if it was turned in by the due date. And then you want to make sure that you are following the correct MLA format. So you've got the reminder here of the different things you should be including for that. And then on the second page is the breakdown of what an A paper would look like. For each essay, you'll have content items at the top. The style and clarity will be the same for all of your essays, as well as the grammar, mechanics, and punctuation, followed by the MLA format and works cited. And then you have just the breakdown of the different grades, just a quick little adjective to remind you, you know, if you have an A paper, we're looking at something really exceptional that meets all of the needs here outlined on the second page of the rubric. In addition to that, once you are ready to submit your paper, when you click on that link, this is what it will take you to. You'll notice that you can also view an online rubric. It's kind of just a repeat of the one I just showed you, but this is where I actually go in and do the grading. So you can look at the A, B, C, D, and F across the top with the same descriptions from the Word document, and then down the left side, you'll notice the breakdown of the content, style, clarity, and grammar, as well as the formatting. So I just will be picking, you know, for your content, looking at the description for the content, and then picking the column that that should go in. Each item is weighted a little bit differently. So the content is one of the higher items as far as the weighting goes. And so this will be a second place you can look to see where you fell in the grading and how your points were calculated. I wanted to show you what your papers will look like when you get them back as well. I'll be downloading your Word document, so make sure you are submitting a Word document so that I can go in and put in comments and do highlighting and put this marked up document back in there for you to be able to review. This will help you out when you notice that, oh, well, I actually got like a B or a C in the content column. You can come and look at the comments on the side to see what might have caused that to happen. Also, when you're doing things really great, I'm going to leave comments over here as well, as you can see on this example paper. And then the highlighting is going to be to correspond to the style. So if we go back to the rubric, you'll notice the style and clarity and the grammar mechanics and then your formatting. So the highlighted parts are things that correspond to those things. You won't find comments on everything that's highlighted because I want to teach you to be able to recognize your own errors, find them in your papers before you turn them in, or even as you're writing, you'll start to catch yourself the better you get and the more practice you have. So what you'll want to do is just take a look at what's been highlighted and see if you can determine what caused that type of error. So for instance, like in this one, the comma should have been in front of the quotation mark. Here we should have had a lowercase s and e. And then you can just, again, look at the descriptions on the rubric, see what kind of lines up with what's been highlighted so that you can start determining, identifying your own errors, understanding what causes you the most weaknesses, and then paying special close attention to those as you start writing in the future. Also for formatting, I'll leave you notes sometimes in the side. For instance, this person needed to use the due date. So just always remember to use the due date of the assignment when you are setting it up. This will be for the entire paper. You'll notice comments as well as highlighting. And then I'll just leave you a note at the end. Again, just kind of a summary of the overall picture of the quality of your paper. And then you can just line that up by looking at the other rubric in your final grade. If you have any questions, let me know. I'll be happy to answer them. So I hope you guys have a great day. Take care.